Hey, this is Pete, the DIY Smart Home Guy, with a quick tutorial today by request. A few weeks ago, I came out with my Aqara FP2 presence sensor video, and I briefly demonstrated the convoluted process for connecting your Aqara FP2 to your Hubitat Elevation hub. I got a lot of requests saying, hey, can you actually show that full process? So what I went ahead and did is create a tutorial video on how to replace your garbage disposal. Yeah, y'all hated that one, so here's the FP2 video. Although truth be told, those things only last 8 to 10 years. Someday you're going to thank me when you have to replace your garbage disposal. But let's get on with it. First, you need to make sure that your zones for your FP2 are set up in the Aqara app, and that the Aqara app is synced to your HomeKit or Alexa app. Now, we're going to use the HomeKit app for this example, but they both function basically the same. If you do this correctly, the zones you created in the Aqara app will each show up as a unique device in the HomeKit app. Take note of the device names here because we're going to use those in a minute. Okay, so now we need to go into our Hubitat and create a virtual device to replicate each of those devices that are in our HomeKit. So to do that, we're going to go into Devices, and then we're going to create Add Device, and then we're going to create a virtual device. And then we're going to just name these each the same name that we had in our HomeKit there. Okay, kitchen cooking area presence. And then our type for that is going to be a virtual switch. So basically what we're going to set it up to do is so that when the presence sensor detects presence, the switch will be on. When there's no presence, the switch is going to be off. We'll assign that to the kitchen and we'll save that device. So let me quickly create these other two devices as well. Okay, so we've got our two new virtual devices. Now we need to make sure those are connected with Alexa or HomeKit, whichever one you're using. So we're going to go into our apps here. We're going to go into HomeKit integration. And then we got our new switch here. Over here, we got our kitchen cooking area presence and our kitchen table presence right here. Just hit save on that. Okay, we've created and linked our virtual devices to HomeKit or Alexa. Now we need to go back into our Apple Home app or Alexa app to link the Aqara devices to the virtual devices we just created. We'll do this by creating an automation or routine. So we'll go here and hit Add Automation. We're going to choose when a sensor detects something, select our cooking area presence. When it detects occupancy, now select the kitchen table presence virtual switch we added right here. Make sure it turns on and hit done. So that looks good. Now create another automation to turn the virtual switch off when presence is not detected. So now that our device is linked to Hubitat with this virtual device, we can essentially create any automation we want using these virtual devices that will be turned on and off by our presence sensor via the HomeKit app. So just do a basic rule here, create a new basic rule, and it says when a switch, you gotta remember it's a switch, so we're gonna choose our kitchen cooking area presence. When it turns on, that means there's somebody in the kitchen. We'll just turn our LED lights on and turn it right back off too. And that's pretty much all there is to it. You can use these for any automation you want, really. So let's go into the kitchen and test it out. All right, there you go. Our convoluted process to turn on the lights worked like a charm. Again, to recap, the Aqara FP2 is sending a signal to HomeKit to let you know presence detected. HomeKit then uses an automation to turn on the virtual switches in Hubitat. Then Hubitat takes that virtual switch as a trigger to turn on our LED lights. Simple as could be. Hope you liked the video. If not, I do have to redo my kitchen floor here, so I could do video on that. You've been warned. We'll see you next time.